Alisal High School, home of the Trojans and home of the 2010 CCS soccer champions. The dream all began here. Alisal soccer program has a long and rich tradition of playing outstanding soccer, and they've always had one goal, to be champions of the Central Coast. But this hasn't been easy. Alisal High School is situated in a battleground of gangs, drugs, and violence.
Gang-related shooting this week in East Salinas, this time on the grounds of Alisal High School.
Last night in Salinas, a 10-year-old girl was caught in gang crossfire.
A gunman shot and killed a 17-year-old in Salinas this morning. It is the latest in a recent string of gang-related crimes in the city.
Five people were shot last night in East Salinas. Two of them are dead.
Well, Dale, another brazen daytime shooting. This time it turns deadly, and police say the victim was simply standing on the sidewalk when someone drove by and opened fire.
A violent start to the weekend in Salinas with four people shot in less than 12 hours.
Salinas is a beautiful place, but it's also a place that's, you know, has its bad side like any other city in the United States. Particularly East Salinas is pretty rough.
Salinas is known for its violence and for, I guess, the Latino race that there is.
This location is the east side of Salinas, also known as the World Salad Bowl. This is an agricultural city where 80% of the nation's lettuce is grown. Most of East Salinas residents work in agriculture.
People here have a lot of spirit, a lot of heart, and they're hard workers.
And everyday hard at work and struggle is evident throughout the community. The majority of the students at Alisal have parents and family members that work in the fields. This is a story of a high school soccer team and their quest for that elusive Central Coast Section Division I soccer championship. This is a story of the Alisal High School Trojans varsity soccer team. Game one for the Trojans, the quarterfinals.
We went into the CCS playoffs, Central Coast Section playoffs, as a number two seed. So we were really excited. I felt that we had the team to win the whole thing, and the playoffs started.
The first round we played against Leland, and we were pretty excited.
The first game, it really wasn't like, it didn't feel like a CCS game. It just felt like another game.
In the first game we played, there wasn't much, you weren't really expecting anything. Anything could have happened.
The Trojans came into the quarterfinals game with a great deal of energy. Sweeper Joni Cruz opened up the marker early in the first half off of a corner kick.
We got a few goals in the first half, and that set the tone.
The Trojans were playing with focus and the need to prove themselves. And after a few more goals, they led at the half 4-1.
After the first few goals, you started calming down, but still you get that sense of urgency. That you want to still keep showing the other team that you've got more to give.
In the second half, Max Estrada sealed the game when he scored the fifth goal for the Trojans. That was just the beginning for the boys. Game two for the Trojans.
We had Sarah next, and Sarah's a Catholic school from San Jose.
Sarah was a pretty difficult team to play.
I knew it wasn't going to be that easy since we were playing a team who was in the WCAL, which is a very competitive league. I knew they were going to come out with everything they had because it's a semifinal and they work hard to get to the final. And I had to give it all I had.
It was very intense. Once we got there, like, we were all nervous because we knew Sarah was going to be a very hard team.
The game was close and tight for both teams. Both teams were playing with everything in their power and were fiercely defending their goals.
It's my belief that we last year had perhaps the best goalie in, I would say, you know, one of the best goalies in Northern California. And Armando Serrano.
Alisal's goalkeeper Armando Serrano was blocking every shot at goal that Serra took. It was an amazing display of courage and determination. The game was tied the whole time, but in the last 10 minutes, Serra scored and shocked the Trojans.
The second game was more emotional just because of the fact that we were losing 1-0.
And my heart sank, man. I thought, nah, this is it. It's not going to happen this year. For a brief second, I thought, it's not going to happen this year. It was really hard to watch them score and celebrate.
When we were down 1-0, it was pretty heartbreaking, but you can't let that shake you down, because if you just shut down before the game's over, then there wasn't really much point in playing at all, you know.
But the boys managed to stay focused, and 2 minutes later, Enrique, Kike, Montano scored the game equalizer.
I kept a positive attitude, and at the end, everything turned out to be well.
We got it together. Like, we kept fighting for that goal to tie up the game, and we did.
We kept our heads up high, and we pressured, and you know, a couple minutes later, we get a goal, and everything just turned around for us.
We turned the game around, and that's due to confidence and the willingness to keep working and working and believing that it's going to happen.
After we scored a goal, there was that feeling of accomplishment, because we were down 1-0, and since we had scored, we could have gone up another one. You always get that feeling of wanting to score another one right away after you score your first goal in the match, and especially when you're down 1-0, you score another one, it catches the other team off guard, and you just shoot at it more and more.
The game was sent to 2 10-minute overtime halves. They battled it out with everything they had left in the tank. After 2 great overtime halves, they ended a tie. The pressure was on for both teams. They were going to penalties.
Going to penalties, well, I knew it was a matter of luck, since penalties, like, don't determine the talent that players have.
It's a very nerve-wracking situation when you're in penalty kicks.
I was nervous going into PKs.
Gerardo Vera shot first for the Trojans. Alisal's goalkeeper Armando Serrano stopped Cera's first penalty kick.
When Mondo stopped the first goal, the first shot, it gave me a slight relief.
You know, we went nuts, man. It seemed in my life I'd always been on the losing end of penalties.
There's no technique to save penalties. You just guess, and guess luck was on my side that day, and I saved that first penalty.
When he first blocked the first PK, it's certainly a relief.
And the rest of the shooters for the Trojans: Enrique Kike Montano, Arturo Mendoza, Joni Cruz, and Eduardo Hernandez all scored the penalty kick. This was a great tough victory for the Trojans, and they did not lose their focus. For the second time in the school's history, they had reached the finals, 5 years after their first appearance.
On the final, it was all or nothing. Either you went for it or you didn't. You just had to fight the whole game until the whistle blew. Just keep going at it.
It was strange feeling going into the final. We had never gotten this far. I had played 2 years prior to that, two seasons prior to that season, and we always came up short.
The final game was, unrealistic scenario. I mean, it was in, once again, it was in, it didn't feel like a CCS final. It just felt like another game against Watsonville, a pretty big rival. But at the end, after, you remember the stuff that happened, you actually appreciate it then in the moment that it happened.
Oh, we came into the final, and not just the final, every game, we know that it's not just about us, but the whole team, the whole community, because they look out for us. They're always looking out for us.
I wasn't sure if we were even in the final, it just seemed like any other game, but it was a big game. You can't really look at it like that though, because if you look at it as something big, you really can't have fun playing it, And that's what we were supposed to have fun, because that's what Cisneros would tell us all the time. You had to have fun playing or else there was no point,
The final, March 6, 2010. The Watsonville Wildcats and the Alisal Trojans are about to play one more crucial game that will decide who is the Central Coast Division 1 soccer champion. Alisal is coming in as the game underdog. Alisal wants to win their first CCS soccer championship in school history. It wasn't going to be easy, as they are battling it out with their rivals, Watsonville. 5 years prior, Alisal lost their first CCS final appearance to Watsonville, 1-0. But this time, a whole new chapter in history was written. Kike Montano gave a long pass from midfield to Lalo Hernandez inside the box, and Lalo headed it to Max Estrada to score the goal in the 21st minute. The play produced both the most important pass and the most important goal in the history of Alisal soccer.
Enrique Montano gave an incredible pass to Lalo Hernandez. Lalo headed it, I don't know how he did it, he beat two defenders, headed the ball, and Max Estrada was at the right place at the right time and put it in with his head, and Max ended up scoring what is considered the most historic goal in the history of Alisal high school boys soccer. And Lalo gave the most important assist in Alisal high school boys soccer.
That was actually unexpected. Every time I see the video on YouTube, I'm just like, wow, how was I at that spot at the right time? But most of the time, goals are like that. You're just in the right spot at the right time, and it just herded it in, and I heard the crowd roar.
Watsonville needed to score, and their attack was relentless. However, the Alisal defense and goalkeeper Armando Serrano were resolute in their denying the Watsonville an equalizer. Armando Serrano showed his confidence and made many more important saves to have a clean sheet. Both teams had more opportunities to score. both defenses and goalkeepers played at their best level of soccer.
In the final minutes, I was more nervous than excited because there was a series of corner kicks that we had to go through, and it was like it was about six or seven corner kicks in our area, and it was a really scary moment, you know.
In the final minutes of stoppage time, it was it was intense, man. They were just getting corner kick after corner kick, and you just wonder when it would end, you know. I was surprised. Those were actually the longest stoppage minutes of my life, you know.
Like, it was forever. It just took forever to end. And then I think the practice before, we had practice corner kicks, and we had like six or eight corner kicks, like one after another, and that's what we had practiced the day before, and that's what we were doing at the end of the final minutes, and we defended well. We defended just how we practiced them.
In stoppage time, it was the longest minutes for many players, the longest 5 minutes for the Trojans. Watsonville was awarded corner kick after corner kick in the stoppage time. The game was intense. In one of those corner kicks, Watsonville had the clearest shot on goal anyone can have. Once again, goalkeeper Armando Serrano made an amazing save that denied Watsonville from scoring.
I just remember reacting to that header, that thing. Christian was their forward. He was a very good forward. Did an incredible header to the second post. I just remember just getting there. It just dove and gave my all and got there.
Oh, I know it wasn't like just one player, but I mean he did his job. He did what he had to do, and like, well, yeah, thanks to him, like that goal didn't go in.
When Armando made that save in that header going across the goalie, I was actually surprised that he even got it, man. Just with a slight tip, he deflected the ball out, and that actually just brought up our momentum and just helped us get that game winner.
Alisal's dreams had finally become a reality. They had become Division I Boys Central Coast Section soccer champions. No one said it would be easy. All they had to do was believe in themselves and play soccer with their heart and passion. For years, Alisal has been trying to accomplish one goal, to be champions. On March 6, 2010, they did it. The Alisal Trojans weren't just playing for themselves. They were playing for one small community, a community where many expect the worst. They proved to many others that no matter how your surroundings are, you can rise above them and succeed. Alisal Soccer isn't just a program. It is a family, and it is a reflection of its community. These 23 young men did what many call the impossible, possible. They proved that together as a team, you can accomplish your goals. Ladies and gentlemen.
Si se pudo.
Alisal, si se pudo.
Si se pudo.
Si se pudo.
Alisal High School Soccer, si se pudo.
When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. And then it goes back, and then it goes back, and then it goes back. Oh.
Born to the throne, stronger than known.
It's not far away, but for now we say,
when I get older, I will.
is leaving us poor.